SpaceX has just approached their first Starship orbital test flight for the first time. SpaceX uses 33 Raptor engines to power Starships, so for every test flight that ends in a non-landing at sea, or in a reusable vehicle, the company will lose 39 Raptor engines. It's a machine, in terms of cost and lost production time, but Musk will embrace the waste of time. The answer is clear and clear. Elon Musk's lack of ideas or innovation skills is also very serious. They are considering using the spacecraft's launch tower to catch heavyweights before landing on Earth. It's an interesting idea, but it has to be realistic. Do you agree with him? Regardless, his technical achievements are definitely worth exploring. To learn more about Elon's genius solution to save all 33 engines. Named after the launch tower Mechazilla character from the Godzilla film series, the Mechazilla SpaceX launch tower is one of the most ambitious features of the space project that led to its new location. The Starship is a reusable rocket capable of simultaneously sending hundreds of people weighing over 100 tons into space. Designed to support all of SpaceX's current missions, and paving the way for more ambitious projects, like moon bases or paved cities to Mars. The largest and most powerful rocket ever launched would be a visually impressive spectacle. But Mechazilla could make the spectacle even more impressive, but it's how portable mechanics guide a rocket to Mars, that NASA explains. What remains of the service structure is on Launch Pad 39A at the Kennedy Space Center. Used in rockets such as the SpaceX Falcon 9 and NASA's decommissioned Space Shuttle, it measures about 347 feet from the ground to the top of the lightning rod, and has three rotating arms to access Space Shuttles placed on the runway. But is ideal for emergency astronaut exist. SpaceX has big plans for the December 2022 Mechazilla theme. Musk says the company plans to use the arms of the launch pad to catch the super heavy boosters when they return to Earth. Musk fans animated interpretations of how it works, and Musk provides more details on how it works. August 30, 2021 The booster itself will most likely use two lift pins and a trap. The boat will have some curvature on the windward side of the boat. Maybe it was part of the front wing, but not the thread of the tank. The booster in your hand aligns it with the orbital launcher and it's ready to fly again. The plan differs significantly from other efforts by SpaceX to reuse Falcon 9 semi-reusable rockets, other efforts to reuse first engine, ground launchers, or autonomous drones at sea. The rocket launches the fire engines, descending and stopping on the runway. That's because using the tower arms to grab boosters and Starship, as suggested on August 13, means you don't have to land with your feet to support your body on the way back. A spacecraft only needs a bridge to land on Mars or other planets, when there is no local infrastructure. The Falcon 9 booster used its legs to hold on, when it landed with this drone. On August 4, 2022, Musk also suggested that the tower could house missiles. On January 20, the respective Musk released the first official preview of SpaceX's plans to capture realistic Super Heavy booster, based on the telemetry simulation shown in the preview. The Falcon brakes as quickly as possible to reduce speed, and make the approach as short as possible, saving a significant amount of fuel during recovery. This means additional fuel that effectively increases the Falcon's dry weight, and reduces its payload if necessary. While in orbit in very heavy traps, splits and Musk, the booster actually lands on a very small piece of steel, in the tower arms rather than a concrete pad. Except for a slight lateral movement on the ground, the hand appears to be stationary during the grip, making it feel much heavier when landing. The slowdown is displayed very slowly during the simulation, and seems to float for almost 10 seconds until the task is completed. For some reason, the SpaceX launcher lands on two overhanging ledges the width of a car tire, so it has to be very precise and very heavy to land on a couple of hard points. Which may require a slow, careful descent and a slower landing. In addition to the need for precise roll control, an inch of lateral defect space and several square feet of usable surface. Even a slight lateral deflection will cause the amplifier to fall off the rack by about 30 meters in a heavy-duty case. Falling onto concrete, which can explode if there is a major anomaly during a landing attempt. Starship or super heavy objects can accidentally damage launch towers or destroy skyscraper-sized structures. After all, the sheer risk of each capture attempt meant that the company would have to be extremely careful. spending and testing a lot of ships and boosters, unless SpaceX miraculously came up with a near-perfect design, for everything involved in the first attempt to avoid this. Only the Starship launch tower has been at least partially disabled. SpaceX will be aware of this, and it looks like the heavyweights will have to function perfectly in good health in the lifting and accelerating parts of their debut launch. Now, if the turret can lift the missile, it will be cleared of capture attempts. And SpaceX reuse rockets are returning to the launch pad position, where you can see the fastest Falcon 9 booster turnaround time from previous flight, to return flight faster than before by 6 hours in March 2021, 2020. Musk said he wants the spacecraft to be able to fly 3 times a day. So if Musk wants to build a city on Mars by 2050, that could start in 2019 after a quick turnaround. He estimates that this city will need about 1 million tons of cargo can reach to Mars to build a self-sufficient city on Mars. If each ship carries 100 tons, that means SpaceX will have to make 10,000 flights over the next 30 years, or about 333 flights a year. That's a pretty impressive number, but as SpaceX tries to grab the Starship booster on its first orbital launch, it's about to launch for the first time, and that flight will most likely happen next month. SpaceX is also working toward demonstrations of the storage and transfer of cryogenic propellants in space. The liquid oxygen and methane used by Starship to fly to and land on other worlds. This, by the way, is very high on their top risk list, Karasich said of cryogenic fuel management. There is a thorough ground test program and, more importantly, a thorough in-space propellant transfer and also measurement of boil-off in-space test plan. During Artemis moon missions, SpaceX will launch the lunar lander version of its Starship into low Earth orbit, where it will rendezvous with a depot. This propellant depot will be optimized to prevent the boil-off of cryogenic fuels in space. Yes, space is very cold, but when exposed to sunlight, objects in space can get very hot regardless. SpaceX plans to load this depot with propellant prior to the launch of a lunar Starship with a tanker form of the vehicle. Karasich was not specific but said it would require, relatively speaking, quite a few tanker flights to provide enough fuel for a Starship to the moon mission. Karasich said SpaceX is presently targeting early December for a test flight of Starship and Super Heavy. Although this timeline is dependent upon a number of factors, including a full 33-engine static fire test of Super Heavy, an FAA launch license, and final preparation of ground systems at SpaceX's Starbase launch facility in South Texas. After this initial test flight, Karasich said NASA is tracking 3 additional flight tests of Starship for fueling demonstrations. The second test, Karasich said, will entail a tank-to-tank transfer of propellant, followed by a Starship-to-Starship transfer of propellant. To a complete fueling of Starship from a depot, and a long-duration flight to mimic the in-space time of a lunar mission. SpaceX plans to keep its low Earth orbit propellant depots, topped off with fuel for missions other than Artemis, Karasich added. So it's not like every time we go to the moon we're going to start with an empty depot, he said. Depending on how well SpaceX's in-flight demonstrations go, Karasich said the nominal target for an uncrewed test flight of Starship to the surface of the moon and back up to orbit around the moon is toward the end of 2024. Thanks for watching this video and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this to make sure you can subscribe. If you have any crazy idea what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we will see if we can get the, and thanks again for watching and goodbye.